Moving on to the financial items, can I have a motion for item D1, approval of request for travel report?
So moved.
So moved by Mr. Phillipsack, second by Dr. Cohen. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Abstained? Motion carried. I'd like to combine items E1, E2, and E3. Does anyone need anything separated out? Seeing none, can I have a motion for personnel items E1, E2, and E3?
So moved.
Moved by Dr. Cohen, second by Mrs. Shaw. Any discussion?
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw?
I just want to remind everyone that in our personnel agenda this evening, Lisa Citron is named as our Autism Spectrum Services Director and Kelly Bond as our Secondary Special Ed Supervisor. I have had the opportunity to meet and hear from both of these extraordinary professionals in our special services meetings. I can't think of anyone better suited than Mrs. Citron and Ms. Bond for these particular positions, and I look forward to the time when they begin to serve.
Good.
Any other discussion? Will the secretary please call the roll?
Mrs. Chu?
Yes.
Dr. Cohen?
Yes.
Mrs. Lax?
Yes.
Mr. McAvoy?
Yes.
Mr. Phillipchak?
Yes.
Mrs. Shaw?
Yes.
Mrs. Becker?
Yes. Motion's carried. Is there any old business? Okay, seeing none. Information items. Anyone have any committee reports, organization reports? Mr. Phillipsack.
January 28th, the same reports, budget reports that were presented today were presented to the Finance Committee. I want to thank Ms. Gulig and Mr. Leopold for their kindness and their presentation and their patience in presenting all the budget requests. I want to thank Mr. Simmons, Mr. Cohen, and Ms. Becker for their participation and their attendance. I want to remind everybody that the budget process is in the early stages. We will review all concerns of all board members, and I welcome them to give me any of their concerns directly so we can bring it to the Finance Committee, and we'll get everybody done and get everything done. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other committee or organization reports? Mrs. Shaw?
Very briefly, the Garden State Coalition of Schools met on January 27th. We talked a great deal about what's going on in Trenton right now, and you may find it surprising, and perhaps not, that education issues are not particularly in the forefront right now. Politics is reigning in Trenton as it is elsewhere during the presidential primary season. So anyway, we talked to some extent about the reintroduction after a two-year legislative term of some bills. We talked about the impact of casinos, finances in Atlantic City, what it might do to their finances to have casinos being permitted in the northern part of the state. Democrats are very hotly seeking a veto-proof majority. Presidential politics, as well as the gubernatorial election, are taking precedence in the buzz around Trenton right now. Again, we've talked a little bit about the constitutional amendments surrounding pension costs, and that this must be separated from general state aid, and it's likely going to result in a decrease in state aid or higher taxes should it be passed. Garden State continues to try to create a public interest threshold for granting charters. So we did discuss at some length charter schools and the regulations surrounding them. Governor Christie certainly wants to see the charter schools grow, and therefore it's likely that they might actually try to lessen regulations on them. And my personal opinion is that they've already been lessened. So that's my report for this evening.
Thank you, Mrs. Shaw. Anyone else? Okay.